Thomas is in Drumchapel. How's it going, Thomas?
How you doing, mate? I'm alright, how are you?
Oh, could be like a local derby, Hugh, if you played Thomas. Were you born in the Drum?
No, I went there when I was 12 years old.
Right.
Where are you, Thomas? Which street are you in?
Don't have you, Thomas, you don't have to give your address away on the radio.
I'll tell you, mate. I was in Kinfauns Drive. There you are.
I'm not far from that, mate. I'm up back. Come on.
That'll do. Keep it vague, Thomas. Don't let them get your personal details out of you. If it's heads, it will be the Drumchapel Derby. And if it's tails, it will be Simon Donnelly. So from nowhere near there. But anyway, where are you from originally, just out of curiosity?
Rutherglen.
Oh, yeah.
One side, yeah.
Okay. Posh boy.
Go. I'll sleep well tonight, I'm just wondering. Right, heads, it was Hugh, tails, Simon, and it is Hugh against Thomas. So what we'll do is give Hugh some greatest hits radio to listen to, and we'll turn it up nice and loud so he can't hear us. Thomas, you have 30 seconds, answer as many as you can, and pass if you don't know the answer. That's my advice to you, all right?
Spot on.
Good man, your time starts now. Ryan Christie has played for Inverness, Celtic, and which other Scottish team?
Aberdeen.
In what year did Rangers last win the Scottish League Cup?
2016.
Who's the only current Scotland player playing club football in Spain? James Frew is the shirt sponsor of which Scottish Premiership club?
Kilmarnock.
What was the score last night between Scotland and Belgium women?
One each.
True or false, Ross County's stadium capacity is bigger than the population of Dingwall?
False.
Hugh Keevins, can you hear us? Are you back?
I am.
He's nodding along. I've heard of dad dancing.
That
madness. What's grandpa dancing?
One night I'll tell you about the time I went to see Madness in concert with my son.
Tell us right now.
Oh no, I can't, because it's got a pretty spicy ending.
Oh right, it might be one of those late night shows.
Yeah.
I'm curious. What did you and your son get up to at Madness?
It was the t-shirt that my son bought and took home and proudly showed to his mother.
Oh, it didn't go down well.
Oh my.
Where was the gig?
What was then known as Green's Playhouse in the city centre,
which is now known as,
I think it's a big pub now or something.
I don't know.
It was a,
I can see you. You know what I mean? I'm looking at you with the shot with the button done up tonight.
Yeah,
he's looking all right.
It was opposite
Suggs.
Suggs McPherson. Yeah. Opposite the Pavilion Theatre was Green's Playhouse, which is a big concert venue.
Oh, okay.
Back in the day, and they were sensational. But my son bought this T-shirt, which contained a very graphic message.
I'm going to look up Madness T-shirts from what year would this have been?
Ooh, now he was a teenager, so. 30 years
ago. So you went along with him?
He was too young to go on his own.
Ah, right.
So I took him and his pal from school, and the pal from school, whose father was the headmaster of the local school, he bought the same T-shirt with the same graphic message.
Honestly. Anyway, I think we got slightly sidetracked there. Let's give Hugh the same questions. 30 seconds on the clock, Hugh, and your time starts now. Ryan Christie played for Celtic, Inverness, and which other Scottish team?
Pass.
In what year did Rangers last win the Scottish League Cup?
2011.
Who's the only current Scotland player playing club football in Spain?
Pass.
James Frew is the shirt sponsor of which Scottish Premiership club?
Pass.
What was the score last night between Scotland and Belgium women?
1-1.
True or false, Ross County's stadium capacity is bigger than the population of Dingwall?
Correct.
That'll be true then.
Yeah.
Thomas, how do you think it went?
It could be quite close, I'm not too sure.
Ryan Christie, Inverness, Celtic,
Aberdeen.
And Aberdeen. Oh. Well done to Thomas. Rangers last won the League Cup in 2011. You both got it. Well done to you. I always think years can be quite hard to pinpoint and get them bang on. 2-1 to Thomas. Kieran Tierney, Real Sociedad. 3-1 Thomas. It was at this point, Thomas, I knew you were either very good, very lucky, or a bit of both. James Frew, was that a guess?
It was a guess, aye.
It's Kilmarnock, he's absolutely nailed it.
I need to clarify, see, for the Rangers Cup, I think I say 2016. I didn't say 2011, I got that wrong, I think.
Ooh, what an honest man.
Honesty,
seriously.
Yeah.
We're all honest in Drumchapel.
It's because he's well up. He's 4-1 up.
There we go. I genuinely wouldn't do you like that. I could have swore he said 2011, and yet the producer said it was 2016, so we'll scrub that from the record. There we go, good on you, Thomas. Very honest, right? So it was 2-1 up to Thomas, then 3-1 up, yeah? We're comfortable with that? Yes, okay. Uh-huh. The score last night, Sophie Howard's 94th minute headered equaliser, 1-1. You both got it. And Ross County Stadium capacity is bigger than the population of Dingwall. So Hugh got three, but it was still a four for Thomas. And finally, after a long wait, we have a victory for the listeners. Well done, Thomas.
Thank you very much, guys.
Well done, Thomas. I'll see you in the United.
Tell you what, that's an absolute show-off moment, that though, isn't it? With the old, I didn't need that one. Take that off me. Uh-huh. To be fair,
I'm going to win fair and square.
Good man. There are no hiding places. Alonso tweeted, "I was just going to tell you." He said 2016. I am very sorry, Thomas. You're a Celtic fan.
We're honest.
Well, that wasn't where I was going with this, but.